This is Short-Term Rental Management, the show that is all about short-term rental property management, with your host, yours truly, Luke Carl. Short-Term Rental Management, exciting stuff today. We've got Margo, CEO of Hostfully, coming in. Some of you may know her. She has been on Avery's podcast, The Short-Term Show. And today we're going to talk a little bit about management and management softwares and guidebooks and the future of the industry and the Hostfully-Palooza that is happening right now. The Integrations Palooza going on now through the 8th of March. If you're listening to this live on Tuesday, March the 5th, we love you. Thank you for being here. And Margo will be joining us after a quick word from this week's sponsor. This episode is brought to you by the premier short-term rental Facebook group, Short-Term Rental Long-Term Wealth. We have nearly 50,000 members. And this is the biggest independently owned and operated SCR Facebook group, and it has been curated by yours truly, Cashflow Carl. Join us on Facebook. Search the groups for Short-Term Rental Long-Term Wealth. That's Short-Term Rental Long-Term Wealth on Facebook. Here we are, ready to party. Short-Term Rental Management, long hair Luke, with Margo, which is lovely to have you. I know you very well from, not personally, but from Avery's podcast. You were on her show about a year ago. So tell us a little bit about yourself and what you do.
Well, hey, everyone. My name is Margo Shmorak. I'm the CEO and co-founder of Hostfully. I live in San Francisco. I've worked at like some other tech companies in the past. And Hostfully is a short-term rental property management software company. So we help focus on software solutions that help any sort of host to property manager with managing their property. We have two products, a property management platform, which it's like a PMS, which is like the worst acronym in the history of our industry. But basically it helps you with getting reservations from different bookings platforms. So if you have a property you're listing on Airbnb, you can use Hostfully to also get that property on booking.com and Vrbo and like increase your occupancy and change your pricing, manage guest messaging all in one place. So it's pretty cool. And then we also have a digital guidebooks product, which maybe some of you have heard about. It's a freemium product. So the first guidebook is free. And then if you want more under your same account, you pay us a small subscription for that. We got our start really with a lot of the folks I think are listening to your podcast, which is like the smaller scale property managers. My co-founder, David, manages his own properties out of his house here in San Francisco. And he and I met back in 2015. And he was iterating on basically he made like a really crappy Word document guidebook for his property. And he was like, there's got to be a better way. So that was the origin story for Hostfully. But yeah, that's Hostfully in a nutshell, and happy to go into more stuff later. But Luke, I have to say that I'm like super psyched to be talking to you today. And I hope listeners listen like soon-ish, because we have this crazy event coming up in next week called Integrations Palooza. I don't know if you've heard about this, but
yes,
I want to
make
sure to talk about that. Okay, good.
Yes, I have. Let's talk about that. Go ahead.
Okay, cool. So this is our first ever conference that we're running with customers and integration partners. And we're like, the vibe is really like we're putting on a big party and we're inviting lots of different companies in our industry to come and talk about what they do. And I hope that people out there will come to some of the sessions, because it's just this really great way of like going to a conference without having to pay or travel and getting, you know, like the inside scoop on what all these different software companies are doing within our space. And we're doing it because Hostfully uniquely integrates with so many other companies. We have more than 60 different integration partners. And so we really know like the who's who in the industry. So we've invited a lot of those best in class partners to come and talk about what they do. And so if you're like thinking about dipping your toe into software, this is a perfect way to just get an overview and understanding without having to commit, you know, money, time, resources, or even your own time traveling to a conference to do it.
So is it my understanding that this started as the guidebook? Which came first, the management? Which, by the way, thank you for making the acronym joke. I don't know that anybody's ever done that. And thanks for taking it there. Guidebook first, management software first, which one?
Well, it's kind of chicken and the egg. So guidebook, I joined with David. We made a guidebook company. At that same time, there was another person named Stefan Osmond who was inventing the PMS, the property management platform. And we, around 2016, 17, we integrated with his product. And David and I also were thinking, like, we got this, we have to figure out a way to make a product that's more urgently needed by our customers. And so we met Stefan at a coffee shop called Flywheel right here by Golden Gate Park. And we were talking about integrations and working together. And I walked away, like literally that day I walked away and I was like, oh, I wish we could get these two companies together. Like, this is the co-founder that we need and this is the company that we need. So we approached him and said, like, how do you feel about making this more serious? And we ended up doing a merger of the two businesses together. It was a lot like dating. I don't know if any people out there have done mergers, but it's really like dating. Like, you have to, like, you want to ask the question, but you're not sure, like, how deep the question should be. But I'm kind of like a crazy person, even in my dating life, actually, too, where, like, I just like to put the hard stuff first. So I was like, let's just start out with the juiciest part of this, which is like, what's the new thing going to be called? Who's in charge? And, you know, how much do you think you're worth? And we basically went from there. So it was a merger that we did early.
Where
days.
Did the name come from? Did he have the name? Did you have the name?
Hostfully was our name. His name was Orbi Rental. And it's a challenging name because you don't know how to say it when you see it written. It's hard to know how to spell. It starts with an O. There's like some branding challenges with that name. So yeah, anyway, we felt pretty strongly that we wanted to do that.
Is he still involved?
Yeah, he's still my co-founder.
Oh, wonderful, wonderful. Okay, so all three of you are still involved.
Yes.
Okay, yeah. Great, great. And this is 2017-ish, you said, and that's kind of when this whole scene was really exploding, right?
Yes.
It was 2018, my recollection, when Vrbo was started to kind of break down their wall and let you in. What did that look like?
Well, actually, it was around that same time. Yeah, 2018, when like the APIs of all the platforms opened up. So it wasn't just Vrbo, also Airbnb. It was like 2017. Vrbo actually had an API earlier, I think, than Airbnb did. I don't know. I have to fact check myself on that. But it was all around the same time. You know, I have two amazing co-founders. So Stefan had a relationship with Airbnb before we started working together. And so that was really helpful. And it helped us get started with like working with Airbnb more closely. And then David is a rabid Salesforce fan. Okay. And like, I'll just like side note for a second. So Salesforce is another company that was built with a platform strategy where it's like you put your data in Salesforce and you could do a lot of really amazing things with Salesforce, but you also tack on all these additional software tools on top of Salesforce to make it personalized for your business, whether you need like really good customer support and you're in the medical industry or whether you need like really great marketing intelligence and you're in consumer products, Salesforce allows you to like select different software partners to cater to that industry. And David had a vision to do that in our industry. And so Hostfully is a platform product where you can tack on additional solutions. And so at that time, David understood, and I did too, but he really understood it better, honestly, because he's an day-to-day property manager. He understood how important it would be to start to develop these relationships with Airbnb, Vrbo and booking.com and others. And we started building out this partner network. And we just got elite status with Vrbo this year. And we're a preferred plus partner with Airbnb. We're actually one of only three companies in the world to have this like top level status with Airbnb, Vrbo and booking.com. So it's something we've been working on for a long time. I mean, I think this is one of those like fallacies of startups is that it's like easy to get going and make a successful business. But, you know, I know now that it just takes time. You need to work well and quickly, but you also just need time to make it happen.
So to have all three of them is a huge deal, right? There's a lot more people that may have just Airbnb or just Vrbo, but to have all three is the pinnacle, really. And what do you make of all that? How many of these, you know, there's hundreds and hundreds of them now. How many of them were around when you first started versus how many came along, and then where do we see those going?
Like PMSs or, yes. Or okay, PMSs. So yeah, there's always been so many, and it like I don't know if people in the audience have seen this like slide. It has like a million logos on it that shows like all the different companies in the space. It kind of stresses me out, to be honest with you. There have always been many, many companies out there, and that's because there's a lot of smart property managers who've basically started in built the software for their own business. And then they were like, you know what, maybe I could like sell this to somebody else. And as soon as they do that, they're commercializing their own software. So they're basically like, you know, creating a little company. I will be honest with you and say that about 4 years ago, it felt so crowded and so noisy and so confusing for the customer. Like everyone's just like throwing out words left and right and not being really clear about what they provided. I was not sure that we were going to be a front runner. I mean, I was like, I'm going to keep going, but I like, this is a very noisy space. And this is like very unpleasant to be in because even if we tell the truth, it's just like really hard for our customers to verify that. But fast forward to today, we've seen a lot of consolidation. So a lot of companies have been taken off the market that are good companies. Like, you know, Guesty bought MyVR. That was kind of like a big signal to us that there was some real consolidation going. You have the whole Inhabit IQ consortium of companies now that have all banded together, like Streamline and LMPM. And I'm like blanking on the other companies in that group. But basically, there's a bunch of different kind of consolidated entities right now. And we've had the advantage of just like putting our heads down and focusing on building really good technology and a really good business. And it's like I was running a marathon and it was super crowded in the beginning. And all of a sudden I'm at like mile 20 and I look up and I'm like, where is everybody? Like, that's how it feels right now. It's great. I'm actually really enjoying it. Like we really appreciate our customers for sticking with us through that really crazy time. And we were excited to continue to build a good business.
Yeah. And it's weird because they came out of nowhere too. You know, I mean, it was literally like 2015, 16, like it didn't really even exist. And if it did, it was, nobody really knew about it. You had Escapia, you know, and a couple of early adopters, which of course is Vrbo in-house basically. But, And then all of a sudden, you know, IGMS kind of popped up a little bit. And then you started hearing about some software, which that one, it's still around, but it's very simple.
Yeah, you have like, like Tokeet was like yeah. There was that company. I think Journey actually started around that time. There's a bunch of other PMS companies that started at that time.
And then literally like overnight, there was hundreds of them.
And
I was completely overwhelmed because it's always been my job to teach people how to manage vacation homes. And I'm like, and I had all these questions coming out of nowhere, like, what is this software, that software? And I'm like, I'll be honest, man, I don't know. It's only been around for 2 weeks, you know? So
yeah, totally. I mean, I was going at that time, I was going to the trade show and sitting through other people's demos. I was just like, nobody knew who I was. It was great. I would pretend I was a customer and I'd be like, yeah, can I see a demo? And they would just like show me their software. And it was like very confusing because I even felt confused. I'm the one who's making it. Like it was terrible. I really.
What do you think sets yourself apart from the ones that aren't going to make it? Just just good old fashioned hard work, or what is it?
I don't think it's hard work. I think you have to work hard to have a successful company. But I actually feel like it really comes down to planning and like really good financial management and having a wonderful like aligned team on what your goals are. So for example, at Hostfully, we've known that from day one, we want to grow really thoughtfully. Like I've had investors who've said, I really want you to like tell me you can 10X this company, which is grows like to grow 10 times in a year. And I just say, no, that's not this kind of business. And they're like, well, that's unfortunate because like, you know, you won't qualify for investment. I'm like, well, okay, we'll have to find another investor, you know? So like, I think from day one, we've been really good about drawing boundaries around like what we think is realistic. And that just, so that, you know, it works well, honestly, it worked really well because I don't attract the wrong investors, but it also works really, really well with customers. Like we really don't overcommit to customers. We never say we're going to do something, then don't deliver on it. We don't overcommit to employees. When we say we're growing, you know, we did like one tiny layoff at the end of 2021 with like 2% of our workforce. But other than that, we've never done any sort of like big layoffs, chunks, you know, swaths of people in the company. And at that time, I mean, it was regrettably that we had to do that, but it was like one to two people really. So I think, you know, I mean, that was just like planning challenges. But I think that overall, what we've done is be really thoughtful about how we want to grow. And we've never had the luxury of having a ton of capital. Maybe I'm bad at fundraising or like just was hard for whatever reason. And so like, we just never really like even had the opportunity to get ahead of ourselves. And that's something that just, is luck because we were raising money at tough times, just the way that the money was used in the business. And I think it's like good planning, hard work, and timing of which it's just fate. Like I can't control that. But like, I do think that the planning and thoughtfulness is really, really important. I see now when I'm evaluating companies, I'm like sometimes I do like small checks in startups, very few, but like, and we're talking like really small checks, investing in them. What I'm looking for is the thoroughness in planning. Like that's one of the, I think a lot of people have great ideas and ideas are kind of cheap and they can talk about them and sell other people. But I think what sets really good entrepreneurs apart is in the planning.
Join me live every Thursday for a weekly Q&A all about short-term rental. If you like my vibe, if you're digging the long hair extraordinaire Cashflow Carl and want to ask me questions in real time, join me at strquestions.com. It's a lot of fun. strquestions.com. Are you a host yourself?
I am. I have a vacation rental in Windsor, which is like in Sonoma County. We don't rent it out very often, though. We usually use it primarily for our own purposes.
Okay, great. Great. Mm-hmm. And yeah, I mean, you know, I'm in long-term as well. And, you know, that space, you really only have like three top dog management softwares, give or take. You got Buildium, Appfolio, and Apartments.com. Those are the ones that come up most often. And if you, especially if you're going to go with a professional property manager, it's probably going to be one of those two, Appfolio or Buildium. So I think that's kind of, do you feel that's where your space is headed? We're going to narrow this thing down to three or four big guys, and then everybody else will they get swallowed up by the other companies, or will they disappear, or both?
I don't think it's going to happen overnight. I do think that we will get to a consolidated form of the market. I think it's probably going to be more like three or four solutions versus like two. Like, I just think it's going to be a little bit more because technology is easier to build right now than it was when Appfolio and Buildium were built. Also, Appfolio and Buildium don't use the same like platform strategy that we're seeing in our industry. So the platform strategy leaves more room for creativity and innovation, which is honestly good for everybody because it means that companies are going to get better at more like specific needs that they're trying to solve versus like trying to solve it all. And like Buildium and Appfolio are kind of like a do it all in one kind of, I mean, for the most part, I think you could tell me I might be wrong, but in our industry, what I think is like, there's going to be continued like platform nature in the industry. There's going to be like three to four big players, but I think this is all not going to shake out until like 5 to 10 years from now. It's going to take some time.
Yeah.
I think it would be really hard for another PMS to get started today or in the future and win. So, you know what I'm, so it's kind of who's on the field right now that we're like, that I would bet on.
I agree. And I think it's been very confusing for the consumer as well, because this space just went nuts. I mean, it's almost like there's a brand new space, but it's really been around for a couple of centuries. It's just changed so much with the Airbnb coming around. Again, you know, people forget Airbnb's only been around really since about 2010, 11. Exactly. It started in 07, but it wasn't even a thing yet, you know, until about, I think they had a Super Bowl commercial in 2010 or 11. Mm-hmm. Was like their big break or whatever.
Coming out. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
And that's only, you know, 12, 13 years ago. Mm-hmm. And of course, Verbo's been around for since the late 90s. But, but you know, it's been very confusing for a consumer to come into this and it's all because as a guy like me, I feel like I have to like, you know every detail about all of the softwares before I can make a decision on which one to use. And I have a very much of a maximizer way of doing things where I completely obsess to the point where, okay, this is why I don't want that one, you know, and then I can move on. Then I can finally move on to the next one. And it did get super overwhelming there for a while. And I think you're right. I think it's probably gonna be a 4 or 5 year shakeout kind of thing. And we'll be left with, I mean, really it already is. I feel as a consumer, I feel like it's pretty much already there. There's like the top six or so. And then there's a bunch of them that I never hear of or never, you know, nobody ever talks about. Mm-hmm. But wonderful. So what do you see in store for not only the industry, but for you guys before we talk more about the Palooza?
Well, it's a great time, like because of this competitive dynamics that you're talking about for consumers to be in the industry, like using software, because as a software company, we are like hard pressed to stay super competitive and innovate really fast. And so like one of the things I always tell consumers to look out for, and I think this is what's coming next in the industry overall, is like the velocity of innovation in a software company that you're going to work with. So it is what features they have today and what functionality they have today, but it's also like how many releases are you releasing, and like what were your last big things that you launched? When did that happen? What's can I see documentation of that? Like we're seeing like a real differentiation between real software companies that are pushing on innovation and leaning on that, and then companies that are kind of like, for whatever reason, not going as fast. And actually, like even with Hostfully, like we love to go fast, but we're not even going as fast as we'd like. So it just like opening the door a little bit to like what it feels like on the inside. Like we want to do more than we can, but one of the most important things that I would tell a friend if they were shopping in this industry is like look for the software innovation, and look for like the customer care and support, like how communicative that company is going to be with you around what changes are going to be happening, and use that as a way of betting on what tool you want to use, because it's a pain in the butt to switch, as
Oh,
you
it
know.
is. It is. Yeah. Switching is a lot, especially if you got a lot of properties, it can be a big pain in the rear. Can you explain to me for like the end user, the relationship between the guidebook and the management software? Is it the same username and password? How does that work?
No, it's actually two different platforms because those companies were separate in the beginning. So because Hostfully's PMS is built with a really strong API, we have an open API for customers to use, but we also have a partner API, which is really powerful. We hooked up the two products together with an API. So it is two different logins and passwords, but the information is synchronized across both. So if you want to like sign up for a Hostfully property management platform, you can create guidebooks that automatically have all the addresses of your properties, for example. You can also do cool things like push lock codes into the guidebooks as a field. You can turn on the guidebooks and turn them off at certain times based on the stay dates, you know what I mean, for your reservations. So there's a lot of like cool things that we've done to integrate the two together, but they are separate products and they're sold separately.
But I could use the same username and password if I wanted to. The software, it wouldn't know the difference.
You could, although we don't recommend that for security
Oh,
purposes,
really?
but
Yeah. Well, yeah. Of course. Change.
yeah.
Did I just sound like an old person? Is that what you're? Is the flashlight on my phone right now?
We recommend using LastPass or 1Password to do all your
Yeah.
password manager. PSA to everyone out there, use those. Thanks. I just started last year. Much better.
Okay. Great. Great.
Yes.
Great. Okay. Cool. All right, so let's talk more about the Palooza, which actually started yesterday. Basically, you're giving all of your partners the opportunity to talk about themselves, and it seems like a really cool event. And it does continue today, starting at noon East. If you can tell us a little bit more about that.
So it's the Integrations Palooza. Very exciting. We are going to be having so many partners. So today, which is March 5th, if you're listening to the podcast today, we have Remote Lock, Clearing, Beyond, which is a price dynamic pricing tool, Homes and Villas by Marriott, Boostly, Safely, Charge Automation. That's today. Tomorrow, we've got Lynx, Guest Guru, Vrbo, Hudson Creative Studio. They make websites. Vacay My Way, which is an OTA, Price Labs, which is dynamic pricing, and Breezeway. And then on March 7th, we have, I'm not going to keep reading, but anyway, go to our landing page, which I think we're going to link to in the show notes, and you can check out all these partners. And what you can do is actually register for each of these sessions individually. So you can just pick off the ones that you want to go to. It's not like we're not going to have like a wraparound software that does the whole conference. It's just like coming into the different sessions. But you're going to have not just the partner that's going to be there, but also a Hostfully team member who will be in the room too. So if you have any questions about the overall event or about Hostfully, you can also be asking them there. So just feel free to join.
Love that. The short-term shop needs to be in on this next year, although we're not a software, so that probably doesn't really work. But
Yeah,
but
but
yeah, this is.
it's kind of a cool idea though, actually, like having an influencer hour or something like that.
Yeah, we'll get Avery in there to tell jokes or whatever. But anyway, so yeah, this starts today around noon-ish. It started yesterday, but it will resume today around noon. And man, this is a star-studded cast. You basically got everybody in the business here, so.
Oh, I also wanted to say that if people are listening to this late, you can go to the link and watch the recording too. So all the content will still be available.
And how do I find that? It's just on your website. It's hostfully.com/integrations-palooza.
That's right. Yeah, hostfully.com/integrations-palooza, and just click into any of these ones, any of these sessions, and it will. I'll make sure that we can get to the recording. It doesn't show it right now because we're recording this beforehand, but I'll double check it later on and make sure that people can get to that recording later on too.
Yeah, this is super cool. Very cool. I love it. So, did Beyond change their name? Is it no more Beyond Pricing?
That was a while ago.
Oh, where have I been?
That was, I think actually that was pre-Vrbo.
Oh man, I'm outdated. I'm outdated on that. Well, let's give me a little bit more on the future of the business. Where are we going with this thing? Everybody's, I feel like we got a pretty good future as far as quality of bookings and health of my listings. I'm excited. I'm excited for a new year. So you have any warm thoughts that we can leave the listeners with for a 2024?
A couple things. Like one is like do your planning, your financial and operational planning because it's going to help you. I think I've said that a couple times, and I know it's different for property management businesses compared to software businesses, but it's still so important. So don't forget to do that. The second thing is that we're going through this big wave of professionalization in the industry where you're seeing things that are really interesting that I think we all knew were going to happen, but we're seeing them actually happen, which is like when you think about, staying in an accommodation, whether it's a hotel or a short-term rental, like those two things are being used interchangeably now. So what that means for property managers is that they need to think about the guest experience like it's that of a hotel, meaning it's consistent, it's high quality, it's very clear to the guest. So I would spend energy thinking about your brand and your messaging and your communication strategy and, your responsiveness when it comes to guests, because I think that we're seeing this, dovetailing of the two industries a little bit, and consumer expectations are really, really high for short-term rentals compared to where they've been before. So that's something that we continue to need to work on as an industry. I also think this is a time to be open-minded about and investing in technology. And we've seen companies use automation in their operations, of course, in their software, but just all over their business and become very, very successful doing so. And it's all about like leaning into a strength. So like there's one property manager based in New Orleans. This is actually if you go on LinkedIn, you can see there's a case study about him. And he's just like leaned really in hard into upsell. So he knows like how to offer guests the right offers at the right time. He does it using Hostfully guidebooks and the property management platform. And he makes like extra money, right, compared to his competitors in region, not on the price of the booking, but on like all the other in-stay services that he can provide. That's one example. Then we've got another property manager who's based in another place who's doing amazing things when it comes to like revenue optimization. And they've been able to get more out of their business from just thinking more smartly about pricing and seasonality and other cool ways of like maximizing occupancy. And both of them, I mean, they both could be doing the other thing, right? But it's like they're not trying to do everything. They're trying to do one thing really, really well. So I think knowing yourself, knowing what you're good at, what you love to do, and then like letting that lead your business is really smart. And we're in this time where I don't think it's going to get tremendously more competitive for short-term rental property managers, but I do think the competition is pretty high and it's going to stay there. And so it's just, it's going to be a hustle for a little while.
Would you say that most of your clients are third party or are self-managed?
It's a mix. It's a mix. I mean, it's going to be like kind of tied, honestly, between the two. We have a lot of small scale managers that are just doing their own, and then we have a lot of professional ones. I mean, if you think about it by property count, definitely the professionally managed ones like overwhelm, but by number of customers, it's probably like close to 50-50. I'd have to check that.
But let's say I'm a noob and I'm trying to decide what software to choose. I would have no reservations going with you, even if I only had one property.
No, not none. And I mean, this is the type of customer that is a really, really good fit for us is this single property customer because we offer a lot of the more robust functionality that some of the bigger software companies offer, but we allow single users to sign up and some of those other companies. don't. Like they have a property minimum, for example, that you need to meet in order to get started with them. But for Hostfully, you can start with just one property. And actually, we've had people who start with one property and they use it as kind of like a testing ground, and then they scale with us, and it works really, really well because they've scaled in an easier way. Like they haven't played things so risky in their business where they're like having to do things for 20 properties all at once, right? They're just doing it for one, and once they get everything perfected, then they can scale it up to the others.
Right. Well, let's face it. It is very difficult to buy real estate, and it's expensive to buy real estate. So taking your time is a wonderful thing. You should
It
probably,
is. It is.
you should probably do that. And I agree. Budgeting is a huge deal. That's very timely and topical right now because we're coming first of the March, and a lot of people have been, a lot of noobs, you'll see them struggle through it. Like most, most markets slow season is going to be January and February, right? Not every market, but most markets. So a lot of noobs didn't realize that was coming, and then they had to come out of pocket for 2 months. So she's right. Margo is 100% right. This is right now is the perfect time to get your budget going for
Yes.
next off season, because you blink your eye and it'll be off season again, so.
Yeah, and actually we see that even in people who talk to us, like, with our team around this time of year. They are thinking really smartly around their seasonality. Like, we like customers who come to us during slow season because, first of all, they're being more thoughtful about their business overall. And secondly, when they're trying to make a decision, they're not feeling rushed and stressed because, you know what I mean? It's never good to be making choices or decisions when you're stressed out, just like
I never
random.
thought about that. The perfect time to switch management softwares is off season, which again, not all the time, but usually in Jan, Feb, depending on, maybe if you're in a ski market, it'd be in the summertime. So, wow,
Exactly.
yeah, put it. I always think of that as my time to paint and redo some tile. And but you're right, man. If you have any interest in
Yeah.
switching softwares, or maybe May, it usually slows down a little bit sometimes. But
Yeah.
wonderful, wonderful. Well, listen, you are awesome. The Palooza begins once again today. So day two of the Palooza starts at noon Eastern time, and you can sign up at hostfully.com. We'll put the exact link in the show notes. Margo, anything else you want to say?
Oh, no, I'm just like a my door is always open. If you or any of your listeners want to email me, my email is margo@hostfully.com. I'm happy to help you in any way. I won't hard sell you on Hostfully. I really just I built my career around helping, and I plan to live my life that way forever. So I really care a lot about this community and overall industry, and just want to be here to support everybody. So if anybody wants to reach out, just have them reach out to me.
Wonderful. Well, you are a ray of sunshine, and I can't thank you enough for coming to party with us here at Short Term Rental Management. Enjoy the Palooza. It's going on for a few more days. And on behalf of Margo from Hostfully and long-haired Luke Carl, don't overthink it.